For the first time in the aquarium's gallery's existence, I feel like I'm doing, for the first time, exactly what I wanted to do with building three individual rooms, each offering a unique and incredible experience. The downside is I was only able to completely finish this room, and the next two kind of have to be bounced back and forth. But I'm going to show you one of the projects that I just had to get to, and I'll show you in a minute. First room that we walk into is what I consider the war room. And or most people will call it the piranha room. This is a 700 gallon piranha aquarium. It's got 36 red belly piranha and 120 red eyed tetras within it. Yes, those are real plants. Absolutely phenomenal aquarium. Look at the tree branches the aqua decor made. They go all the way through the tank. Just absolutely gorgeous. I can sit right here, drink my coffee, do some editing. Make sure the security cameras are there so I can kind of see around the house if I'm ever in here, because this is a kind of concealed room that you can't really see out of. Fridge filled with fish food, some drinks, you know, microwave to heat up my coffee if it goes too cold. Artwork my daughter made me. Cleaning supplies. Over on this side, of course, is a few shelves. Right now, it's just gonna have some batteries and charging thing. Cart on wheels that has all the food in it, so I could just wheel it around and feed the fish individually. And then, of course, the main... Well, I also have this wall, and this... Well, I'll just explain what this is. This is stuff I always lose. Yes, I've got toolboxes, but you know those one or two things that you're always losing. This is actually measuring the temperature of that room over there and this room. This room's a little warmer right now because I'm in it. But I just kind of wanted to point this out because the temperature in there is currently set to 27. It is 27 and it's 28 in here. A lot of people were worried about how the temperature and air circulation in here is going to work. But as you guys know, we have a massive air exchanger that's built into the wall up here behind that plant, and it pumps out over on that side. We have tons of these fans all around blowing, and then of course on the other side of the wall, which you guys really like this door. I like it because it's like soft closing. I made it that way. It's not supposed to do that, but I think it's really cool. Now if I want to keep it open, of course, I just did this. Yeah, it's ugly, but it works. Now, like I said, I gotta bounce back and forth between all the rooms here and do a few things, but one of the things that I wanna talk about today and the project that I wanna show you is the aquaponics room. This is gonna be a 180 gallon aquarium. This is going to be a 180 gallon aquarium. I've already built the stands. We'll see that in a future video. Two tanks here, 3 feet of distance in between, and then the same idea on that side where the tanks go this way and that way. I'm gonna build up false walls. It's going to be absolutely amazing from the outside looking in. You'll be able to see through the aquarium, but what I'm doing with those walls is going to be a massive game changer. I think you guys are going to find it absolutely amazing. But then again, we have the 2000 gallon room where this wall is going to be up. You'll be able to walk through this into the aquaponics room, which is surrounded by the 180s. And it's mostly, this room is going to be a couch. You can sit and actually enjoy the 2000. You're going to be surrounded by salt water as well as fresh water. I'm getting to that. Oh, there's so much more to do out here, and I am getting a lot done. It's just like, I've got to bounce back and forth. For example, I want to build my aquaponic system. So first thing I had to do was move the 180 gallon aquarium, or the 375 gallon acrylic aquarium back down off of the 2000. Because obviously I'm doing something different over here. That tank weighs 400 pounds. I really shouldn't be moving it by myself. Chances of getting hurt are high. But it's also acrylic, so I can kind of drag it around, not really worry about it cracking or breaking. And I put it back on its stand kind of thing on the floor, and I painted it, well, it's only got one coat, but I painted it the same color as the floor, just to kind of blend in a little bit more. Now, before I go full blown into aquaponics and truly do something with this room that I really want to do, I figured I'd dabble my feet in first and see how I like it. And I decided I'm just gonna go with like 18 plants. I wanna grow tomatoes and lettuce and herbs. But I also wanted to build something that you guys can literally do in your home aquariums right now without even having to upgrade anything. Let me show you what I did. First and foremost, if you don't know how aquaponics work, isn't this cool? Like, this is super, super, super cool. First of all, this is how aquaponics work. You put your plants in here, and they feed off of the water in the aquarium, sucking out all the nutrients, phosphates, nitrates. It's a natural biological filter, as well as this filter media, which is just expanded clay, acts as a biological media as well. The tank is filled up with water, and I've got a large canister running it right now just for additional biological filtration, but I do need to put more circulation on this aquarium in general. I'm most likely just going to put a couple wave makers on the end just to circulate the water. We're going to get to what we're actually stocking in here shortly, but I kind of want to point out, I want you to see that this aquaponic system doesn't take away from the aquarium at all. We can put whatever we want in here. We can also still access the actual fish. Okay, here's how I did. I took some Rubbermaid totes and I drilled 4 massive holes in the top. They're just 4-inch holes, but you got to do it abundantly slow because this clear plastic is incredibly brittle. I made them so that they are 4 inches in diameter, which is going to hold some plastic planter cups. Then, of course, drilled holes all through the sides, and I used a step drill to do that. That was a key component to building these. Again, it's super easy to break this plastic, and there's probably, yeah, this, I stepped on it by an accident. They do break easily. It's not a big deal. $8 for the top and bottom. The base of it is 4 inches deep. These cups are, 3 inches deep, something like that? No, the bases are 6 inches deep. The cups are 4 inches, something like that. You'll also notice that half the cups are actually submerged and the top half isn't. This means I can plant into them and the roots can go down into the water if they want to, but I'm also got them in this bin to protect them from fish from eating or attacking them or anything like that. As for the lids, I cut the holes out of the lids to the size of these containers. I simply just drop them in because I don't want too much water getting out. I don't want fish jumping out. And I kept these straps on here as well. I cut along the other side so that this will bend and works like a normal aquarium lid. The lighting that we're using are just LED lights that you would get at your local hardware store. They're technically LED grow lights, only using about 9 watts. Hopefully these will do just fine. I'm not happy with everything. Again, I'm just kind of throwing everything together to get a good idea, but I can raise these and lower them. And you'll remember I showed you how to build these as well. These are just upside down plant pots and then some lights that I got on Amazon. Everything here, dirt cheap. So this was $10. Each one of these was 25 cents. So, I mean, what am I in here? $11. And then I believe I'm using about 2 pounds for each, and 2 pounds was another $8. So $20 to do this. And then we got to look at plants and whatnot. So $60. Each one of these lights, I think we're probably close to about $15. So $369. You know, we're not looking at too much here. And it is a really nice introduction to aquaponics. Even though I've shown you guys how to do this for years, I think it was 7-8 years ago, I was showing you all different methods and types of aquaponics, from even just adding the common houseplant pothos to your aquarium. You have no idea why I had to make that video either. I was getting hounded and chastised and criticized for using pothos in my aquariums, and then I make a video about it and explain why I do it. Next thing you know, everybody's doing it. But it's not even something I invented or I started. People have been doing that for years. It's just when you bring something to the masses kind of for the first time, a lot of people just don't understand it. Anyways, as for stocking, I'm not going to be eating the fish. Fish are friends. They are not food. I don't know what I want to do, but you guys also always want me to try keep silver arowana again. I used to keep them years ago. Of course, never seen them on this channel, but maybe we could do some big catfish in there, but I do want to have some type of a big monster fish in there. It is 375 gallons. It is 8 feet long by 3 feet wide. I'm not putting my stingrays in there. I'm not putting my Asian arowana in there. They are for the 2000. So we got to figure out what we should put in this tank. Let me know what you think it should be in the comment section below. Should we get into the red-tailed catfish again? I know that I've already kept one, and the sole purpose of keeping one was to show you a couple of things. First and foremost, look how fast these grow. I got it from this size and it got to this size in no time flat. And then I showed you, if you must keep one, here's how to build a cheap, large indoor pond so you could actually house them properly.
the point was never to keep the catfish for life. It was more for educational purposes. However, perhaps we look into another one as again. Again, you guys got to let me know in the comment section below.
This isn't a massive aquaponic system, but it is pretty cool. Of course, I can only add six. There's only two. Two times two is... There's about 4 square feet here, and I'm technically only supposed to have 4 cups. I added 6. You do need space for each plant. And the way this simply works, there's so many different ways you can set up an aquaponic system, whether you're using floating styrofoam, or you know, you have runways, or you have some sort of a flush-through system. There's all different ways. And I wanted to try this way because, first and foremost, I've never seen anything like this before, and the idea kind of just popped into my head. Look how... It looks like this is supposed to be like this. Like, this looks like something you would go buy. Of course, maybe it would be a little bit more refined, but isn't that cool? Now imagine plants all growing up through it. Just going to be absolutely gorgeous. Yeah, so let me know what you think about this. I already got the plants. I got to start, you know, doing the seeds and whatnot. It'll be interesting to see if they survive. Oh, this is cool. So fish can't jump out, and they're not going to be able to lift that up. Yeah. Such an awesome system. I thought you guys were going to enjoy this. So I had to show it to you sooner rather than later because the next things I got to do is move the 180s, then build more 180 stands, then set the 180s up, build up the walls, the filtration, get the 2,000 gallon room done, move the 70 gallons, stock those. There's a ton of things we have to do. But everybody is doing fine out here. I'm excited to finally have a space that is just absolutely amazing. It's really difficult to explain a lot of things right now and the end result of how this is all going to be, but I'll summarize it quite simply. I want the aquarium gallery to be a place that you can come and enjoy aquariums. I want it to feel like almost like you're in a house or in an area that you could have this in your home and gives you ideas and different things. But I also want each room to offer me something different. I want the 700 gallon war room. I want the 2,000 gallon to be my pride and joy. I have never sat in front of the 2,000 gallon ever and actually just enjoyed it. I'm always squatting or looking down or building something. This gallery is going to be done one last time and then I'm done because I have other rooms I got to move into. My entire basement I'm renovating for fish tanks. And I have a whole new building that I'm building with 120 aquariums in it, minimum, thousands of gallons. And you know, there's plenty more to look forward to in terms of like do-it-yourself projects and constant videos that you guys might enjoy. But this here is going to be designed around a place that I can really enjoy and that you guys can come along with me. I don't know, the basement's going to be absolutely crazy as well. I used to like, what do you guys think about this? Should I do this? Should I do that? I'm not doing that anymore. Maybe for the new building, we'll get some input. But just like... opinions and suggestions, I'm certainly always up to that. But right now, plans for the gallery are final. I'm absolutely doing them. You'll have to wait until it's finished, but I can promise you, you're going to love it. Like every aquarium I ever set up, most people don't like it until it's done. It's tough to explain your visions and that sort of thing to somebody else because maybe I'm just not good at explaining it. But you know what? I really like this wall and every day I add to it, like measuring tape. I'm always losing my measuring tape. So I'm just taking these screws and I just form whatever I'm losing, put it there. Yeah, maybe we'll go through this entire room and I'll show you everything that's out here. If you guys want a real tour, we'll have to do that at some point. But I want to get back to work today. I want to finish. I got to build the stands for the 180s or at least go pick up the wood. Oh! And underneath these stands will be 40-gallon breeders, most likely going to have discus in there for now in a couple of them, but in others, they'll be used as quarantine. I got to rebuild the entire filtration system for the 2000 in that room, as well as the 700. I got to make an entirely new display here. Right behind us, we're going to have a 70, another 70. It's going to be a couch in the center. I'm wrapping it with the same thing that's on this wall. I don't know if you guys have even seen all this. I know I showed all the members everything, but I don't know if you guys, like everybody's seen it, but I'll be wrapping it in this so it kind of matches, but I'm not positive if I want that look yet. I have to repaint these floors because obviously it's not done. But if you remember, all this is painted, but if you remember behind these tanks, well, here's some example. It used to be all black walls. And now it's gone completely back to white. It's much brighter out here, much more enjoyable. And I think you guys can agree.
Oh yeah, also I shortened the 70 gallons. They used to be up here. I was going to make them as tall as the 2000, if you remember, but I made them even shorter. They now only stand about, I don't remember. Total, and that is the height of the back of most couches. I want to be able to sit it and kind of be side by side with these tanks where I literally just look over and I can see the saltwater tank, or I look over here, I see the puffer tank. And I don't think I told you guys that's what it was going to be, but that's what it's most likely going to be. And then I look across from me, I look down, and there's a wall here now. But in that wall is a 180 gallon built into it. And then I look over, and what appears to be a doorway, and I say what appears to be a doorway because, well, you guys got to wait to see what I'm actually building for this wall. Nobody has any idea except me, and I love it. And I look over here, another 180, you can see, and I think we're going to do... I know I'm doing planted discus. I'm going to get back into them a bit, but then you walk in and we have an aquaponics room. You look over here, another 180 and another 180, but now you're in a whole new world with a whole new experience. It's like kind of tinkering around, checking on things, making sure everything's okay, feeding the monster fish, taking care of the tanks. You know, walk out here, relax and, you know, enjoy the 2000 gallon with monster fish in it. Walk out here into the war room where everything truly gets done. And if you got some time, sit down and enjoy the 700. But the basement, I think, is going to trump everything. I think that it's going to blow your socks off when it's done. Stand still now, probably about 2 more months before it'll be completed. But this stuff should get us through the winter and keep us occupied until the spring when the new the building happens and foundation is laid and all that stuff begins to happen. If you guys can't wait to see that, let me know in the comment section below and subscribe if you're not already. Like the video. What else do I gotta say as a YouTuber? To be honest, I really just wanna know your thoughts on the aquaponics system. I don't care if you think about anything else. See you guys in the next video.